ਸਸਰੇਕਾਲ ਪਿਆਰਿਓ ਮਮਾ ਮੰਗਦੇ ਆ ਇਸ ਰਾਤ ਨੂੰ ਅਗਰ ਮੈਂ ਤੰਗ ਕਿਤੇ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਥੋੜ੍ਹਾ ਜਿਹਾ ਟਾਈਮ ਚਾਹੀਦਾ ਜੇ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਮੰਗਦੇ ਆ ਹਾਂਜੀ ਮੈਂ ਹੀ ਸੀ ਜੈਨੀ ਸੁਰੇ ਦੀ ਮਹਿੰਦੀ ਕੀਤਾ ਸੀ ਹੈਲੋ ਐਵਰੀਵਨ ਲਵਲੀ ਗੈਸਟ ਸੋਰੀ ਟੂ ਡਿਸਟਰਬ ਯੂ ਔਨ ਦਿਸ ਬਿਊਟੀਫੁਲ ਈਵਨਿੰਗ ਆਈ ਵੋਂਟ ਟੇਕ ਅਪ ਮੱਚ ਆਫ ਯੋਰ ਟਾਈਮ ਯੈਸ ਆਈ ਡਿਡ ਯੋਰ ਹੈਨਾ ਦੈਟ ਵਾਸ ਮੀ It's an absolute pleasure to be here working for all of you. I just wanted to say a few words to introduce myself, really. So, hello everyone. Oh, I've got a lot of weddings. the beauty, the artistry, the traditions, the food, the time it takes. I've never quite comprehended how sometimes a desi wedding can last 5 days. 5 whole days of the celebration of love, of family, togetherness, and seeing how happy everyone is to be with one another, how happy you all are. I do recognize some of you from pictures and Facebook. And obviously the beautiful Dali, our blushing bride. Red really is your colour. I should clock me now. And you, Arjun, you are one lucky man. Handsome as ever. Yes, cousin, it's me. I'm here. I made it. Oh, I realise there's lots of you that don't know me, that haven't known me, but you will. You will. Oh no, please do continue to eat. Don't let me stop you. And definitely try the jalebi. Heard it's disgustingly tasty. I've got a sweet tooth. I want to tell you a story of the little brown sheep. Long ago, there was a little sheep. She was 10 years old. One midnight, she laid in her bed as she heard her mother on the phone in the bathroom across the hall. She was speaking to the man that came and went. A distant stranger, her father. Sitting bolt upright now, she was excited. A pit in her stomach fell deep as she heard tones in her mother's voice she wished she hadn't. She calls out, "Is that Daddy on the phone?" Confused as she hangs up without letting her speak to him. Her mother gets the sheep out of bed. Unusual considering the lateness of the hour. Normally she'd be told off for being awake so late into the night. And she sits her down on the lid of the toilet seat and perches down beside her in the dark bathroom. She very slowly explains to the little sheep that Daddy is getting married. And to an Indian woman. It'll be a huge celebration. The Indian family will congregate from miles and miles to celebrate this partnership. His whole family will be there. The little sheep reads the confused and deeply distressed lines in her mother's face and tries to work out their meaning. She very slowly explains to the little sheep that she has a very grown-up decision to make right now. If she goes to the wedding as Daddy's only daughter, only child, she will not be allowed to call him Daddy in front of anyone, under any circumstances. The little sheep thought long and hard. She thought about all the other children playing, running around at the wedding, who would have much bigger roles to play than she. She would be a stranger. A far-off relative, a distant friend's child, but not his daughter. The poor, confused, pained white mother tries her best to explain to her little brown sheep that she, as a product of white and Indian love, 21-year-olds out of wedlock, that because of who she is, what she is, what she stands for, she has been kept a secret. The little brown sheep brings shame on the flock, on the family, on this family, on you. Of course, there was a second option, not go. So she decided not to go. Didn't she, Dad? Sasori Godfather. Many years later, the little brown sheep is 18 when the second wedding of the family happens. Aunties! Could this be a chance for reconciliation? Wrong. Rejected again. She's a woman now, she knows what's right and what's wrong. A grueling conversation with her grandmother, the leader of the flock. She wants an explanation, she wants to know why. Words are spewed at her, so venomous, she loses sight and all recognition of the person speaking to her. The person that supposedly loved her. Her Naniji. Don't you dare walk away from me! How could you treat your family like that? Refusing to see me until I was 3 years old was one thing, but what's worse is afterwards you made me believe you loved me. I haven't finished! I am your granddaughter! Why are you so ashamed of me? I thought love and kindness was everything, isn't that what the gurus say? God blesses you with another day, in return you try to be better. You're not one of us, you never will be. You're mixed race, you were born out of wedlock. Well, introduce them to me. Your 30-year-old dirty brown secret. Or should I carry on? No? Okay. I will not allow her to use my wedding as a platform to announce her existence. Ta-da! Naughty, naughty! Dali. Beautiful cousin. God, you really do look glorious. I know you didn't want me here. Oh, Grandad, Naniji. Hey, remember setting me up with a pay-as-you-go phone so I could chat to my friends? Thank you. And thank you for screaming at me for answering the phone to a man who rang me thinking this was indeed your phone. The man, your brother, who was ever so intrigued to know my name and age when I told him that this was indeed his brother's granddaughter's phone. I'm sure you're here somewhere, Uncle. Well, now you can put a face to a name 17 years later. So here I am, family. Drinking, smoking, depressed. Warts and all. What you do with this knowledge of me, of my existence, I don't care. You will see me. You may not like me, but you will not forget me. Vaiguru says love one another and treat everyone equally. It says so in the Guru Granth Sahib. So I assumed you wouldn't mind. Cheers to family.